Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do everyone. My name is Serena and I'm the president of Syncopasian. We're so excited to have you all here with us tonight at our Spring 2021 concert, Silver Linings. We have a full set list and plenty of entertainment prepared for you tonight. To view our concert program, please click on the QR code on screen or click on the link in the live stream chat. Before we continue on with the rest of the concert, let's take a quick detour to visit a fellow Synco.
Hello there. Welcome, welcome. So kind of you to come visit me here today in my humble abode. Surely you're here to see the vast assortment of rare goods I have to offer. Take, for example, this ancient artifact. It hails from the faraway land of Dining. The inscription on top reads, "Whosoever holds this takeout box, if they be worthy, shall possess the power of Gordon Ramsay." That man always knows how to please, and he'll never serve it to you raw, although some prefer otherwise. Or perhaps, you'd be interested in this antique relic, a monument to those poor souls tormented by the geese on campus. Oh, how I've missed those geese. I've been on many a long walk this semester, more so to maintain my own sanity than anything, instead of being holed up in my room all the time. But I finally found a chance to explore the city and get to know its waterfowl. Fascinating, isn't it? You seem disinterested. Ah, but I have just the gift for you. That, right there. Well, not you. I'm sure you're great as well. I'm talking about that device in front of you. The one you're watching us on at this very moment. Wherever you are in the world, you're able to join us tonight. And you've taken the time out of your day to do so. So thank you. We have a wonderful night of marvelous music and splendid stories of our own little silver linings ahead. So buckle up and enjoy the show.
Song, I want to give a quick shout out to one of our graduating seniors this year, Melody, aka Queen of Durian. If you don't know Melody, you can quickly identify her by her obsession with durian, her deep soothing tone, and also her I am an alto but I really want to be a tenor energy. One of my favorite memories with Melody was during the fall of 2019, when we went to Boston and went into a restaurant with a lot of durian-themed foods, and that was so fun, both because of how good the food was, and also because I got to know this amazing human being a little bit better through our small talks about family, life, and more. Melody has contributed to Synco in so many ways. She joined Synco during the fall of 2017 as a freshman, and during her time in Synco, she has served many leadership positions as president, stage director, concert chair, publicity chair, and webmaster, and she really kept the group going strong. I can confidently say that Synco would not have been the same without Melody. In addition, she has had some amazing musical contribution to Synco as well. She arranged the piece Brother, which is currently playing in the background. She's an amazing soloist as well, soloing a total of eight songs over the course of her years in Synco. Melody, we love you and we all miss you a lot. Please come back and visit us often.
I'm taking 714, Human Cultivation and Maintenance. And they gave us a real live human for our final project. This is Melody. garden variety 6-3, transplanted recently out of MIT. Today, I'm going to show you my tips and tricks for cultivating a human. First is feeding. Humans don't have to take in any sunlight directly, so all you have to do is provide enough glucose and they sprout nicely. For instance, take a look at Melody's head foliage. It's kind of long now. Wonder if it needs a trim. Second, troubleshooting. Sometimes Melody starts to wilt and turn gray around the edges, especially under her eyes. The way to combat this is to speak to your human. They require high levels of interaction, even more so in a virtual environment. Observe.
Where the fuck is this bug happening? Oh, why? Where is it?
Oh yeah, I hate bugs. Chew up the leaves, get in the soil, real pain.
What on earth?
You try pesticides? Maybe off or taro? I don't know, something a little stronger?
Maybe? Okay, let me try this. That's a good idea. Oh, frick! Are you kidding me? I forgot to cast an int to a double. Oh, that's wild.
Double bugs? Ew.
Yes! Okay. Beautiful.
I help Melody with her pea sets every night. It's normally lots of pest control, so I'm always happy to lend a leaf. Finally, the last thing is to encourage your human. Melody works so hard, and sometimes she forgets that even surviving and doing as well as she has is impressive. Aw, look at her. Hey, you're aspiring really well, and you make great CO2. Very tasty. You know, even if the bugs keep attacking, it's okay. Sometimes we need them for pollination. I know this semester is very, very different from MIT's natural soil, but you've already grown so much in your new environment, and I can't wait to see what sprouts next. Rest well, human friend. Keep it up. We'll get some sunlight tomorrow.
Hi, everybody. So our next song is a little different from the rest of our program today. In light of recent events and with May being Asian American Pacific Islander Heritage Month, we wanted to perform a work that celebrates all that the Asian community has brought to the United States. In this arrangement, we feature a poem titled Things We Carry on the Sea by Wong Ping, and we invited Asian members of the MIT community to help bring this project to life. There are systemic problems facing the Asian community in the United States today, as seen by these rising cases of anti-Asian hate crimes. We also wanted to use this performance to promote a cause that will help tackle the problems the community faces. In our YouTube video description below, you will see a link to a Facebook fundraiser for the organization Asian Americans Advancing Justice, Asian Law Caucus. This organization is the nation's first legal and civil rights organization serving the low-income Asian Pacific American communities. They focus on a variety of issues, ranging from immigration and immigrants' rights, to labor and employment issues, to civil rights and hate violence. If you have the means to do so, it would mean a lot to us, as well as the AAPI and Asian community, if you could donate. After this next performance will be an intermission during which you can take the time to consider donating. We hope you will join us in supporting the AAPI and Asian community, and we hope you enjoy this performance. Thank you.
We carry tears in our eyes. Goodbye, father. Goodbye, mother. We carry soil in small bags. May home never fade in our hearts. We carry names, stories, memories. We carry scars from proxy wars of greed. We carry carnage of mining, droughts, floods, genocides. We carry dust of our families and neighbors incinerated in mushroom clouds. We carry railroads, plantations, laundromats, nursing homes, hospitals, schools, temples built on our ancestors' backs. We carry old homes along the spine, new dreams in our chests. We carry yesterday, today.
Oh, too far, but I like the way we are. Right here I give your heart a home, 'cause it's not about me, it's not about who I wanna be, it's not about you. You know that we're better off with you, 'cause we are, we are, we are, we are more. Yeah, we are, we are, we are, we are more together.
Hi everyone! Before we begin the second half of our concert, we wanted to take a moment and announce our upcoming album, Intersection. Intersection features a collection of songs from the past 3 years of Synco, including our 2019 ICCA set. The music you just heard during intermissions was a small sample of what's on this album. Intersection will be available on major music distribution platforms, including Spotify and YouTube Music, starting May 28th. Check it out as a study break and to help wind down from the semester.
Professor, I think you're muted.
Right. Thank you. I am Dr. Avid Dattenborough, your professor for 7420, Social Animals and Their Environment. Now, before we continue, I would like to ask you to turn on your cameras, if at all possible. It's much easier for me to lecture to actual human faces than to a silent wall. Now, okay. So, to begin to understand social animals, we must first start by understanding animal intelligence. On what basis do we determine how intelligent an animal is? Now, if one considers that with respect to the numerous ways...
I already told you, Mom! I can't eat breakfast right now! I'm in class!
Huh?
Yeah, I told you! Oh! You go eat first! I'll go eat later, okay?
Well, after all, having breakfast is important indeed to be a social and intelligent animal. But anyway, let's get back to it. Now, I have a question I would like one of you to answer, which is, what are some of the measures of animal intelligence? Anyone? Now, if no one is going to answer, I'm going to pick one of you randomly. Let's see, Alice, do you want to give it a go?
One way to determine animal intelligence is the radial arm maze experiment.
I'm sorry, but is it possible for you to turn your camera on? It makes it much easier for me.
Sorry, excuse me for eating, but...
See trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Whoa.
I see skies of blue. Blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Think to myself, what a wonderful world.
The colors of the rainbow.
Now, before we move on to our next piece, it is time to introduce our second graduating senior, Rachel Zhang, also known as Rachel T. If you've ever met Rachel, you will know that she is an incredible force of nature. Not only because she studies physics and is about to embark on her PhD, but because her laughter is absolutely contagious and leaves no one untouched, even when she's laughing about things that are definitely not that funny. Throughout her years in Synco, Rachel has worn so many hats, from music director to social chair, from concert chair to publicity chair. Rachel has been an absolutely integral part of our group and has pushed all of us to keep improving ourselves to become better musicians and better people. The song she has chosen to perform tonight for her senior sing-out, A Little Happiness, brings me back to some of the best memories I have shared with Synco. When we watched this movie at a retreat house in New Hampshire, and then went out to look at the stars together. Even though the song is called A Little Happiness, Rachel, you have brought so much more than a little happiness to our lives. And I am so thankful to have met you and to be able to call you one of my best friends for life. We will miss you so much, Rachel, and we thank you for everything you have done for the group.
我听见雨滴落在青青草地，我听见远方甲壳钟声响起，可是我没有听见你的声音，认真呼唤我姓名。爱上你的时候还不懂感情，离别了才觉得刻骨铭心。为什么没有发现遇见了你是生命最好的事情？也许当时忙着微笑和哭泣，忙着追逐天空中的流星，任理所当然的忘记是谁风雨里一直默默守不在原地。原来你是我最想留住的幸运，原来我们和爱情曾经靠得那么近，那为我对抗世界的决定，那陪我淋的雨，一幕幕都是你，一直不沾的真心与你相遇，好幸运。可我已失去为你泪流满面的权利，但愿在我看不到的天际，你张开了双翼，遇见你的注定。全是段跌跌撞撞的旅行，拥有着后知后觉的美丽，来不及感谢是你给我勇气，让我能做回我自己。也许当时忙着微笑和哭泣，忙着追逐天空中的流星，任理所当然的忘记是谁风里雨里一直默默守护在原地。
来你是我最想留住的幸运，
everyone. In local news, MIT physicists have discovered flaws in our current understanding of physics, and in particular, how time works. Isn't that exciting? Joining us tonight to discuss this discovery is Dr. Maxwell Wang, MIT theoretical physicist. Good evening, Professor.
Hello, thank you for having me.
So talk to us, Maxwell. You say that our current understanding of time is incomplete?
That's exactly right. Millennia of human attempts to measure and understand the flow of time. It's quite trivial to see that they're all deeply flawed.
Haha, wow. That sounds Incredible. Since you're your team, you found a way to change the flow of time.
That's right. Einstein's theories of relativity predict that under some circumstances, the perceived flow of time will be different for different observers. Really trivial stuff, conceptually, but this is only possible under really exotic conditions, at near light speeds.
And we don't usually move at near light speeds, do we?
No, we don't. Well, not unless we wake up 5 minutes before a Zoom meeting is happening, that is. But generally, it is quite non-trivial to achieve those speeds. So this effect doesn't really come up much in our day-to-day lives.
But what you guys have discovered is a way to change the flow of time without needing such exotic conditions?
That's exactly right. What we've discovered in our most recent research is that there are actually non-relativistic ways of changing the flow of time. It's quite trivial, really. All you need to do is lock yourself in a one-bedroom, one-bathroom, $2,000 a month apartment for 1.5 years, staring at a computer for 12 hours a day.
Yep, 2 pepperoni pizzas, cheesy crust, please. Thank you. And, haha, you're saying I can try this at home?
Yes, regular folk, just like you and me, and all reviewers, are doing it all the time, actually.
Well, that's just shocking. What's an example of when this happens?
Well, just the other day, I was typing up my bibliography when it suddenly hit me out of nowhere. Tuesday was just a few days ago. This is the same week. It really does feel like we're living the same day over and over again. And the paper submission deadline I thought was in a week or so, it's actually due tomorrow. Quite trivially, the only explanation was that the flow of time has been disrupted.
Wow, I'm glad you were able to keep up with your momentous physics research while at home.
Yeah, it's quite a miracle, in fact.
Well, we're just about out of time, but before we end the show, any last thoughts you'd like to share with us, Maxwell?
Well, yes, actually. Before I go, I'd just like to acknowledge how a lot of my students have found this semester pretty challenging academically. I just want to let everyone know that it's quite trivial, actually. Whatever problem you have, just tailor, expand your way out of it.
Well, isn't that just something? Thank you for your time, Maxwell. We trivially appreciate having you.
Yeah, thank you, Brad.
I don't want to wonder if this is a blunder. I don't want to worry whether we're going to stay together till we die. I don't want to jump in unless this music's thumping. All the dishes rattle in the cupboards when the elephants arrive.
I want to love you madly. I want to love you now.
I want to love you.
I want to love you madly. I want to love you, love you. Love you madly.
Pretty, but they're pulling down the branches of the tree.
I don't want to think about it. I don't want to talk about it.
When I kiss your lips, I want to sink down to the bottom of the sea.
I wanna love you madly.
I wanna love you now.
I wanna love you, yeah.
I wanna love you madly. I wanna love you, wanna love you, love you.
Before we present the last song of the night, on behalf of all Syncos, I would like to sincerely thank you for being here with us tonight at our Spring 2021 concert, Silver Linings. I would like to give a huge thank you to the following individuals and entities for audio production. And I would like to give a huge thank you to the following individuals and entities for video production. I would like to thank the following individuals and entities for funding this concert. And thank you to the language speakers that participated in the Things We Carry on the Sea music video. Thank you to the animators from The Borderline at MIT for the animation in the What a Wonderful World video. Last but not least, shout out to our amazing music directors, Justin and Daniel, for leading music rehearsals and coordinating audio recordings. Shout out to our stage directors, Melody and Janice, for leading choreo rehearsals and coordinating video recording. Shout out to our production chair, Aslan, for coordinating audio and video productions. Shout out to our publicity chairs, Derek, Grace, and Cindy, for running publicity campaigns for the group. Shout out to our concert chair, Rachel, for coordinating concert logistics. And finally, shout out to our amazing Synco babies, Shinkai, Max, Grace, and Cindy. You all have been amazing this semester.
The flowers fade and die like the hearts of lovesick girls. Human relations last because of people like the Galactic Repairmen to love and support us throughout. Though the lives that we dream of with the things we carry on the sea have struggles that seem way too big to overcome, there are still moments in life that make us go, wow, what a wonderful world it can be. Ah, life, it's all about these little happiness that you find and also the people in your life that love you madly. Even when we lose faith in our ability to attack on the titanic struggles in life, it's in these silver linings that we find the strength to march on. We have one last song for you tonight. Please enjoy the Attack on Titan medley.
Let me fly.